Peter Tosh wailed words like bullets, and ironically, he got back bullets. Sometimes those words, the ones we ascribe as bad, jarred the notions of good taste and public acceptability.
The death of Bonnie Wailer is the end of an era, the end of Jamaica's greatest reggae group, the Wailers. Here is a profile of one of the legendary members of that group, Peter Tosh, who left us in 1987. Some men suffer in silence, looking the other way and mumbling under their breath about the wrongs they see in life, silenced by a seeming powerlessness to do anything about it. Not so with Peter Tosh. He was defiant, furious about the truth, apartheid, Africa, equal rights and justice, and ganja. Yes. He was a Wailer, a founding member of a triumvirate of Jamaican talent whose lives are interwoven with the development of modern-day Jamaica, and particularly the development of its popular music. Peter Tosh wailed words like bullets, and ironically, he got back bullets. Sometimes those words, the ones we ascribe as bad, jarred the notions of good taste and public acceptability. But it was all Tosh had as a means of crying out, as he had been charged to do from the very beginning of his career.
Quick, until the school teacher tell me that he can play piano.
And that was where we realized that he had an inclination for music. He used to be in the singing groups, he used to be on the junior choir.
Yes, he used to sing. For me, it was about 4 years ago. He used to sing and collect monies. The stroke that I did was shilling days. Chopins and shilling, and people gave it to him for he could sing. But he used to sing Christian songs.
Where you gonna run to, oh, cinnamon? Where Well, we didn't start as a trio, we started as about a seven. About seven people was in the group at the time. Even Joe Higgs used to sing with us once upon a time. So it started from a huge group, which was a family-like.
After seven albums and many singles, we are again presented with yet another case of a brilliant but unfulfilled talent. Tosh had an excellent voice that often showed traces of his church choir beginnings, and his rhythm guitar had a distinctive sound. His death is a serious loss. Outside of Jimmy Cliff, he was the only reggae superstar whose international stature was capable of giving reggae music the leadership that it had lacked since the death of Marley. Personally, he was very misunderstood, but I found him kind, friendly, and humorous. His place will not be filled, for he was truly the toughest. He was an original.
Man off the back.